just come up for a tea break. You know how much I love tea. So I just added some sugar and the sugar disappeared. We've been talking so much about materials and substances and their properties. One of the important properties is solubility. When a substance or a material is added to water, and if it completely disappears in water, it is called soluble in water. If it does not disappear completely in water, it is called not soluble or insoluble in water. And this property is a very important property. For instance, metal does not dissolve in water. Metal is insoluble in water. That's why all our cooking vessels are made of metal. On the other hand, soaps and detergents are soluble in water. That's how we can use them to clean ourselves and wash our clothes. Let's check which substances and materials are soluble and insoluble in water. Let's go to the lab. I have collected some metal coins, marbles made out of glass, a plastic bottle cap, sawdust, which is wood, sand, a type of soil, some sugar and some salt crystals. I have with me 7 beakers filled with water. We'll start with a metal coin. A metal coin is made of pressed metal and I'm stirring it. The next is glass marbles. I'm sure we all have glass marbles at home and all of you must be playing it. I think that's enough of stirring. We'll leave it aside. The next item is a plastic bottle cap. We have different types of plastic bottle plastics at home and we can try with different things. I think that's a lot of stirring. We'll just leave it aside. We have some river sand. You can also take some beach sand or you could try with the different soils. The black cotton soil, the red soil. And we're stirring it for some time and let's leave it. The next is wood shavings. I just got these from the sawmill. I went to Dahanu. So I'm stirring the wood shavings. You know, in our forest, we have different types of woods. There's wood of the teak, the ayn, the boar, the khajuri. I'm adding a spoonful of sugar and let's stir it. Did you know that sugar was discovered from sugarcane by the Chinese? That's why in Hindi it's called the chini. We'll stir it and leave it for some time. And finally, I have some salt crystals. I got these from the Dahanu Agar. All of us have been to these salt pans at Dahanu Agar, where crystal salt is made. These salt crystals have a cuboid shape and they are perfectly white. Stirring them, hopefully they'll dissolve. As you can see, the metal coin has not disappeared. Neither has the glass marble nor the plastic cap. The sand also has not disappeared and nor have the wood shavings. All these materials are insoluble in water. On the other hand, the sugar and the salt have completely disappeared in water. Both these substances are soluble in water. So you saw that some solids like glass, metal, plastic, wood and sand are insoluble in water. Some solid substances like salt and sugar are soluble in water. But these are all solids. What about liquids? Liquids can mix with water or not mix with water. Let's try with a few liquids. We have some lime juice, vinegar, petrol, and our cooking oil. We could use some other oil as well, but for the moment I have taken cooking oil. I have added a few
food coloring to the cooking oil so that it shows up clearly against water. Vinegar is also transparent. To make it show against the water, I have added food coloring to that as well. Let's start with lime juice. I'm adding a little lime juice to the water and stirring. And you can observe what's happening. Next, we'll add some vinegar, to which I've already added some food coloring. Now we'll add some petrol. Watch what happens. I'm stirring it continuously and I'm trying to give it a vigorous shake. You can see that the lime juice has mixed well with the water. It looks uniform. The vinegar also has mixed well with the water. It looks uniform. The petrol has not mixed with the water. You can see the petrol has separated from the water. The water is below and petrol is floating above. Similarly, the oil has not mixed with water. The oil is floating above and the water is below. So now you have learned that solids such as salt and sugar are soluble in water. When you add them to water, they completely disappear in water. Some solids such as glass, metal, plastics, wood, soil, these are insoluble in water. They do not disappear when you add them to water. For liquids, we don't use the word soluble and insoluble. We just say whether a liquid mixes with water or does not mix. Oil and petrol do not mix with water. Lime juice and vinegar mix with water. Some gases like carbon dioxide and oxygen are also soluble in water. Remember a can of soda or any other carbonated beverage? Soda is nothing but carbon dioxide dissolved in water. So when you open this soda water, you can see the bubbles coming out. These are the gas bubbles of carbon dioxide. Just like this, the fishes and other aquatic life, they are able to breathe underwater because oxygen is dissolved in water. Solubility also depends on many other factors, but we'll study them later. Bye.